so I can see. Greetings, welcome. Thank you for stopping by. Relax. Here at Bloom From Within Love, here on TikTok Live. Hope y'all doing well. Something great. The last time I logged on, it said something good. Now I said something great. Something great, right? Collective, it's time for something great. Great, okay? We'll be doing a reading here in a little bit, okay? But before I got into the reading, I wanted to just create a little atmosphere, relaxing, as if you came to visit old Bloomy Bloom. Okay, pretending like you came on over and you in old Bloomy Bloom's living room, okay? And we're going from something good to something great. Yep, it's actually possible. Something great. But it is about shifting our focus. Okay, we talked about that a little bit. When I came on earlier, we got a little mini reading for y'all. I haven't uploaded anything. I had a busy day today, so I apologize for that. Haven't had a chance to upload all of the others, but I will get to it, I promise. So now I'm like ending my day. I'm wrapping it up and slowing it all down. And I'm excited. I'm excited for myself, but I'm also excited for you all collective if this is you. Where your spirit guides, your ancestors, source, the universe is helping you to become open and expansive to the higher energies. You have dealt a long time with navigating the lower energies due to your surroundings, your environment, your friends, family, lovers, whomever that kept you in that energy, that wanted you in that energy, right? So now, it's not that, you know, you're going to go about life, you know, closing your eyes to things or pretending. It's not about that. It's just about the expansion and understanding your power based on your own frequency and your own vibration, right? To ascend and create expanded, higher vibrational experiences, going from good to great. It's actually possible. And I know we spend so much time on the other stuff, you may start to feel like it isn't, but it actually is. So that's kind of why I wanted to create this scenery. This is my space, but I'm hoping to like infuse I'm sorry you hear the washing machine in the background, right? Okay. So I messed up the whole get down a little bit. Because y'all, you hear the washing machine and shit. Woo. It's like, what's that sound? Right? It's the washing machine doing some spin cycles. So I apologize. You hear that part. Y'all weren't supposed to be hearing the washing machine. You're supposed to be hearing the relaxing, you know, busting over jazz and stuff. And the soft candlelight and the cool little, you know what I'm saying, ambiance here. But I'm doing this for a reason. I'm wanting to infuse this, to send this. Because I can recall a time when I wasn't in here. When I was in an environment, in an atmosphere that was like, who did it and why, man. You know, it's a part of the growth. It's a part of the process. It serves us, okay? They say don't despise humble beginnings, you know. But now I'm starting to believe, yeah, make sure that it ain't to do with some kind of curse and hex from haters. Deal with that. Send it to their bitch ass. But outside of that, outside of that, we still eventually can get to a place like this. And like this, I'm not saying this is all that. For me, it's about atmosphere, okay? It's not about, it has to be name, brand, top of the line, this and that. That ain't my get down, okay? To me, it's all about energy. It's all about frequency. It's all about making an environment comfortable and cozy for yourself. If you're going to spend a lot of your own time, it ought to be something that's soothing to you, especially your home. Okay, and everybody's got some different tastes, so I'm not saying that this is your taste, but this, you know, coming from Bloomy, my oasis, if you will, that I create my oasis from within. I create it wherever I land, right? But I'm grateful to be in an energy where it's in a better environment, and hopefully to get the collective that I typically serve an energy of understanding. Yep, you can go from rags to riches. You can go from, you know what I'm saying, grungy to good. And you can go from good to great. From the inside out, you can co-create. So it's almost like, oh, training ourselves now to shift focus. It's a big deal. Okay, especially when we've been used to, I can attest to this. I mean, I'm admitting this on my own side. It's something that my guides are constantly working with me with retraining and refocusing and then sending energies that are not mine back to people. Okay. As an empath, as an hioka, you know what I'm saying? Being able to feel everything, it can be frustrating. But you know what I'm saying? Sending things back to people. I don't have to just sit there. And then refocusing myself. I don't have to just sit and, I can feel this person's stress. Or I could feel, you know, this individual sending, you know, whatever. It's like send it on back to their asses. And then, you know, and then come back to loving, expansive, I am kind of energy. And then watch, I promise, watch what you create, okay? So once I end this, because I'm going to end this here in a few seconds here, hopefully the washing machine finishes cycling out, or I should just go cut it off. Then I'm going to do a reading on something great. Yes, something great. How about that? Don't y'all want to hear something great for a change? Okay, I'm addressing high vibers, you know, those of positive love and light energy that's on this path, that is really giving it all they got. It's time for you all to not only hear something great, but have your focus shifted to something great and realizing that, yes, you can co-create something great from the inside out into your reality. No longer feeling overran or overtaken by the external energies around you or by the energies that people want to project towards you. Okay. I do still highly recommend constant working on the subconscious. It's something that I do. And it's something that I recommend. The subconscious is a major factor. So my resonance is this is something on a daily that it would serve us to address on some level, whether it's just listening to something. Okay, we don't have to always go deep. But even if it's listening to something from 5 to 10 minutes a day, okay, to deal with your subconscious is going to, you know, help tremendously. So be guided, because not everything out there is of love and light energy. But be guided, ask your guides what would help you to reprogram your subconscious. You know, you can ask about a specific area if you don't want to go broad. okay? But that's going to play a major role in what you're co-creating too, okay? So daily, whether it's at night when you go to sleep, in the daytime when you wake up, when you go to the gym, when you, however creative way that you want to use that, dealing with your subconscious, okay, light team, source, Gaia, what sound frequencies, what subliminals or things that are of love and high vibration in the name of deconstructing the subconscious lower vibratory programs that I have, you can say that, right? That I have from my past, from my bloodline, from my family, from the traumatic events, you know what I'm saying? Whatever it is, conditioning. You can even say dealing with narcissism, narcissistic conditionings, okay? And they'll lead you to something. And you can do this while you're on a treadmill. You can do this while you're doing a nature walk. You can do this, you know what I'm saying, while you're on a, you know, cycling, gardening. This doesn't have to be something super hard and deep. So I still recommend doing that on a daily basis, even if it's 5 minutes, guys. And it's the consistency that builds the momentum. That's what's going to also give you power to change. Because you know how we have the momentum and the habits and everything is deeply ingrained? It is. So trying to fight with yourself, the ego, the lower mind is going to give you a run for your money, okay? It's going to give you a nice run for your money because our lower mind and ego is designed to protect us, to survive. It's trying to survive. So instead of trying to fight, it's more about acceptance and then using technology and high frequencies and things that will bypass things and get to the core so that you're not going into so much resistance. I need to be different. I need to be different. Okay, well, let's get to the subconscious. Okay, and let's work on that daily. And then set the intentions, okay? Because it is our actions, you know. I wish I could tell you guys that all we had to do is say a prayer and all we had to do was go to a sermon, a service, a Reiki session, a this or that, and then that would be the end of all things and your life could be great and wonderful and brand new. And I wish I could say that, but that's not quite accurate. This is, as long as we're here, constant co-creation. So it requires active, willing, intentional action from the inside out constantly. Yep. In order to shift. Now, it's easy to stay the same because the conditioning and the momentum has been there. So this is why we find ourselves in the habits. It's been there. Okay, we got it from our parents, we got it from the bloodline, we got it from conditioning, culture, surroundings, environments, we got it from, you know what I'm saying, the experiences. So this is why it's so comfortable and very easy. Now, but trying to get out of there, if you will, one of the easiest places to start is sound frequency, brain technology, because it's about the hardwire. Okay, that's one of the simplest, quickest, and easiest places to start. And I recommend doing something fun, something that's easy, something that you're not going to be looking at like drudgery. That's why I said when you're, you know, exercising, when you're on a treadmill, when you're doing a nature walk, when you're doing busy work, let's say you're gardening, you're washing dishes, there's so many creative ways. And then you'll start to begin to see the power to actually decide something different, to break free of certain habits, to incorporate better type of habits, right? You'll see yourself feeling better, able to change your vibration, not so overrun and overtaken by everyone else's thoughts and perceptions and attitudes and frequencies. And it takes time. And it's, we're all working on this. Okay. Even those of us that's ascended past you, or we're on a different phase or stage, it's still something that we constantly re-look at and adjust and work on when we feel like we're getting off kilter, okay, to get us back into, listen, whatever we're paying attention into is what we're going to constantly make. And yeah, we have to address the lower frequencies, yes. We have to address, you know, when things are happening to us. But the more we can kind of try to get in it, a neutrality, deal with it, get back to what we really want. What do you want? What do you want to create? Forget what you don't want. We know what you don't want. We know what you're tired of. What is it that you would like to create in your life within yourself? And I know it's cliche, man. And I know it's like, yeah, but how do you get into that feel good feeling? How do you get into alignment with all of that? And I believe it's really about intention and trying to just go with the ebb and flow of when we find a vein of something that feels good in a good way. Of course, we're not talking about, you know, feeling good off of something negative, malevolent, or toxic, but in a good way, if we can get in that vein, what elicits positivity for you? Not toxic positivity, where you're trying to avoid. We're just simply talking about co-creating as you have addressed whatever is needing to be addressed. But now, what elicits feel good? What elicits hope? What elicits positivity? What elicits possibility? What elicits joy, bliss, peace from a loving, high vibrational, expanded perspective? What is that for you? For me, ambiance. It's nothing like getting into a comfortable atmosphere where you feel like, you know, where I feel like I can just sit down and relax and enjoy some nice, comfortable music, soft lighting, not be bothered by the external world, and just breathe and look at pretty things. If you guys know, I like sparkly lights. That's why I got a lot of lights throughout my house. I have a lot of, you know, hanging lights and flickery lights and stuff. Because it just elicits magic to me. And there used to be this place in California that I used to go to called Victoria Gardens. And if you were to go there at night, the whole place is lit up. You know, they have the trees and everything. And it just elicits magic, bliss, peace, love, hope. Okay. And they have a similar place in Nevada that I used to go to that was very similar to Victoria Gardens in California. And it has like that same, you know, atmosphere. If you go there at night, you see all these lights and everything like that. And so for me, this is what helps elicit joy and peace, right? Creativity, colors, vibrancies. So I really am asking guides to help me to assist the collective that I serve with getting the energies and the focuses on all of that is good and great and grand that you all are manifesting even now, okay? That sometimes we get distracted because we can still sense the density, the lower energies, especially from the haters. You're going to always have that. So being able to just shift right through that, like it is what it is, but we don't have to stay there. Okay. We can return to sender. Y'all know me. I'll go on a rampage in a minute. Okay. I'm going to be visiting places soon. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, at the same time, you know, it's also about, okay, getting back into your vibe and the things that elicits joy and all that. Because listen, guys, I promise, man. If we are surrendering to our higher self, source, or spirit guides, ancestors, and we're really truly embracing this path, you know, it's not always sunshine and roses, but, you know, I want to say it becomes more sunshine and roses than it was prior, than it was while dealing with karmic shit, lower frequency karmic shit. I promise you that. I can promise you that, okay? It's very well worth it. All right? So with that being said, thank you for visiting old Bloomy Bloom. About that. It's been cutting off a lot lately. But I just was saying thank you for visiting me in my living room. And I hope the comfort that I feel sitting in my own living room, I hope that it provided you with some sense of relaxation, sense of feeling at home, a sense of feeling safe, a sense of feeling cared for, nurtured. That's what I hope the little music and the atmosphere provided for you. So as I close this out, I'm going to tap on the screen to get a love message to prepare us for the reading. We're going from something good to something great. So we're going to wrap it up. I'm going to tap on the screen right now to get our final love message that's going to set the tone for the reading that we're about to do. We're going to get into y'all. Okay. All right. Let's rock. Let's do it. Okay, let's get the tone lighting for the reading we're about to get into here momentarily. Let's get a love message to close this out for the collective that's going from something good to something great, right? Great. And it is possible. All right, let's see. What is the closing message? Temporary heartbreak. Ah, I feel like with that, the universe is saying to you all that, you know what? What you've gone through was temporary heartbreak. Okay, and now you're moving into something great. You went through temporary heartbreak. So you're now going into something great. Couldn't have chose it better. Love is near. Didn't I say it? Your love is near. You're going into something great. So many of you may be experiencing temporary heartbreak, or maybe you experienced in the past temporary heartbreak, and now love. Love is here now. Finally, hello. Okay, let's see. I love playing with this, so I always get caught up because I'm like, ooh, I like playing with this. Okay, I'll be good. So three is the magic number, lighting. Three is the magic number. Okay. And once again, I just want to say thank you, okay, for coming to visit me in my home, in my living room, and I hope you felt comfortable here. All right, so let's see. Find, yes. Get out there in life and co-create and find what you have truly been manifesting, okay? Things that are great. Going from temporary heartbreak to something great. All right, I'll see you guys in a minute with the reading.